All right, round two has begun. We won the die roll and two mountains bolt. Don't think I want to keep this hand. This deck has enough ways to kind of come back and draw a bunch of cards. So I am going to mulligan this hand. And this hand is pretty great, so I'm going to keep it. We both mulliganed, and that's a preordain? It is a decent turn two play, so I guess I'll keep this. Let's see, I'm on the play. Yeah. Sometimes I'll ship it, but you know, this is one of those games where like, yeah, maybe I could use a little bit of deck manipulation, and I don't really see myself doing anything on turn two. So we're gonna play first. Lead out with the cliffs. Playing against another blue deck of some sort. This is so awkward. Just always playing around days. Flame Slash. Cast Preordain. Yeah, this is okay. If my opponent dazes my Preordain there, like, they're just back to one land, which is totally fine by me. You know, again, this is the matchup where if you just kind of get to the late game, everything is, the matchup ends up being very, very good for you. With my unlimited knowledge of the format. But it's a good thing we play the land just because, you know, to avoid getting our Flame Slash dazed. So Brainstorm is in this deck. I guess it's for the flip on the Delver, but generally speaking, not a big fan of Brainstorm when you have zero ways to fetch. And I'm looking at a lot of other mono blue aggro lists and no Brainstorm at all in the 5-0 lists. Really want to draw a land here. All right. So I'm going to play a Seagate Oracle because, again, all right. I want to be able to cast a Mole Drifter if possible. All right. You know, we're in no rush. My opponent's representing counter magic, so I'm just going to hold on to the Mole Drifter. Just extract maximum value. Then my opponent has a Spellstutter Sprite, which I think I should just Lightning Bolt to avoid, you know, having another Spellstutter Sprite get me. All right, let's cast Compulsive. My opponent's just gonna counter everything. All right. Eventually something's gonna resolve, you know? Something. The mono blue deck does seem kind of sweet. Spire Golem, Frostburn Weird, Gush. All right, Gush is nice. Okay. Does my opponent have a counterspell? It's just like I don't want to walk into my opponent's counter magic, you know? When they just pass with two mana up. At least not on like an evoke. Play out Seagate Oracle. The perfect card to bait a counterspell. Looks like my opponent seems like the type of player who just will snap off a counter on basically every threat that I cast, so I'm just trying my best to play around that. Logic Knot, interesting. I see a lot of lists do play one copy of that card. All right. That's a good one. Counterspell is nice. It helps me fight some cards, but again, I just want to hit my land drops. I think the longer the game goes, the better it is for us. Heck, I might even want to like evoke Moldrifter and then like have Counterspell. What is this? Stitch Drake. Is an additional cost to cast Stitch Drake. Exile a creature card. Okay. I'm wondering if I should use the Counterspell now. Just to use my mana. And if my opponent fights, then I can like Flame Slash and play something else. Alright, I'll go with the Counterspell now. Because there's a lot of ways my opponent can actually save it. So, yeah, okay. Alright, so let's lead out with a Peregrine Drake. See what my opponent has here. Wow, all of the counter magic. All right, don't daze me. All right, that was good. We've gone through most of my opponent's card draw. So I am going to attempt to cast Moldrifter now. Or Counterspell, rather. Okay. Well, this Archaeomancer maybe is safe. Maybe not. I'm just going to get... Actually, I'm not sure. Do I want Counterspell or Compulsive Research? Let's actually go with Counterspell. Don't have any lands to really discard. And being able to protect the Compulsive seems good too. Although, right now, like, let's see. I guess I can Compulsive. Just too much value. I can't discard two cards here. I just can't. And I want to play around four spike at least. So I'm just going to preordain next turn. Like I'm just, yeah, trying my best to play around the shenanigans. Because my opponent has a lot of shenanigans. All right, let's go with the preordain. We still have double Counterspell up. So this goes on the stack, then I'm going to Lightning Bolt it. That way my preordain can resolve. My opponent will Vapor Snag and I'm going to counter this. Yeah, crazy stack. So with the Peregrine Drake, we can generate infinite mana. So I guess I'll do that. Oh, wait. I can actually keep both. Yeah, I want to keep both. What am I doing? Put on top. And we'll do this. Also, at this point, I think I have enough mana that I probably just want to cycle. Yeah. Three, four, five. Okay. So two, three, four, five. Peregrine Drake. All right, we'll tap this for mana. One, two, three, four, five. All right, so now we will attempt to go off. My opponent has F6. So let's get back the Ghostly Flicker. Tap for mana. One, two, three, four, five. I misclick something. Just keep doing this. You can also like gain a bunch of life too, right? Is this permanent? Yeah, you can gain infinite life too. Like if this was a real life thing, you could have gained infinite life. But right now, yeah, I mean, we've won the game. Like, it's gonna take some time, folks. So I'm gonna actually pause this now and do this loop until I have a bunch of mana, and I'll resume. All right, well, I just started casting some creatures and then my opponent conceded. So yeah, that's just kind of how you win. You know, we had the Seagate Oracle. If I didn't have the Seagate Oracle, then it wouldn't have done anything. I would have just gained a bunch of life. But because I had the Seagate Oracle, I found a Mole Drifter, which found another Mole Drifter, and the Peregrine Drake, and yeah, you just kind of take over that way. So this version of the deck is playing Spellstutter Sprites, Fairy Miscreants, and presumably Delver of Secrets. So I think Electricery is likely good here. Let's go with Dispels as well. They have a ton of counter magic. Pyroblasts also go in. And let's, again, try to figure out how to sideboard. So I am on the draw here, so I can probably shave a land. Probably this. I think we can shave some of this. I don't think you ever want to cut Preordain. It's just cheap. How good is Seagate Oracle? So they play Ninja to Deep Hour, so it does do a good job of blocking that, but it doesn't block anything else. Maybe we can shave one. Yeah, outside of that, I'm not really sure what else to cut. I like Flame Slash because it kills Spire Golem. I'm not sure if my opponent plays it, but I assume that they do. I might have seen it in the last game and just totally forgot. So we have a lot of removal here. Maybe one of these expensive cards. Maybe like one of the Peregrine Drakes and maybe two of the Peregrine Drakes. Sure. Peregrine Drake is the only card that doesn't really give you any value. Perhaps it could have also just been the one Ghosty Flicker again, because you don't really want to draw too many in your opener. All right. I guess I'll play the Swiftwater Cliffs to try to get the Delver. Really hoping this doesn't flip. All right, no flip is good. Hope this doesn't end a Ninja to Deep Hours. Okay, that's also good. All right, so what do I want to do? I think I want to make sure, I want to hit my land drops, so let's Preordain. My opponent can Spellstutter Sprite here. I want to bottom both because I really want to find lands. Boomerang. Wow. Interesting. I guess I will Lightning Bolt the Delver. All right. I mean, that wasn't too bad. I mean, considering I don't have a land to play next turn, you know? All right. There's the Geist, which is actually pretty annoying. Maybe gets us. Yeah, maybe the Electricery is just not necessary because we have so many ways to kill their creatures. Okay, and then now we're gonna get some good value with Electricery, maybe. Wow. No lands is quite unfortunate. Yeah, I just have to go for this. Like, my opponent can very easily have, yeah, some kind of blast, but... Alright, perhaps boarding out the land was greedy. Definitely suffering from doing that. Alright, so this one is definitely snowballing in my opponent's favor. God. Okay. I guess we just kill this. This is not a great feeling to have to do this. I think if my opponent had a bounce spell, they would have used it there. All right. Yeah. All right, I'm gonna still fight this out, but. Let's preordain. And. Bottom, bottom, and dead. Okay, all right. I think, honestly, I know it was good that one match, but I think we just take those out. Bring that back in for sure. Maybe the extra Drake. This is kind of slow too. Maybe like one. We still have like a decent amount of like good value cards, but I'm just trying to figure out the other cards. Like what else is good? Archaemancer is a bit slow. And again, having the problem with the Peregrine Drake, like it's a good card if you can resolve it. Maybe going down to three is okay. And we'll try one Ghostly Flicker, I guess. Or do I just want Seagate Oracle? Seagate Oracle just doesn't block anything. All right. I guess this is the kind of the same way we boarded in the other blue matchup. All right, yes, we have lands we can keep. All right, so I'm gonna start out with the Swiftwater Cliffs because my opponent can have Delver. Okay, that's good for us. This is a this is an excellent starting hand. Let's go ahead and preordain. I'm gonna keep all the lands. Yeah, boarding out of lands probably really bad. Yep. That's the thing. This deck has a lot of ways to just kind of spin its wheels, if you will. Whereas the blue-red deck has like, you know, actual hard card draw. The draw go game. Bone splitter is good. All right, let's attempt to do this, I think. This is bad against like counterspell plus days, I guess. I kind of want to resolve it. Don't do it! Yeah. Maybe I should have waited. Maybe I should have waited. Yeah, that was really bad. I totally punted that turn. I can't really beat this card. That was a huge mistake. Yeah. My bad, folks. That feels bad. My opponent like sandbags these until they can play two in one turn. So my opponent actually is playing this deck pretty well. And I should just start trying to cast Mole Drifters. Wow. That's one of those like, please, please. One of those please moments. I'll just take three here, no big deal. Actually, let's see. My opponent could have Ninja the Deep Hours. Actually, maybe I should just block. Although, if my opponent Ninja the Deep Hours, maybe they attack with both. No, they wouldn't want to throw away a random creature. All right. So my opponent didn't have a counterspell last turn. So that means there's a pretty good chance they don't have one this turn either. So let's just go for it. Probably has like spell stutter sprite or something. All right. So we played this game quite poorly, but we're not getting punished too hard. My opponent probably just has like bounce spells and a spell stutter sprite. Which is okay. Just keep trading. I mean, this is just getting me like 3 for 1 every turn. Alright, Gush. And it still has one island in hand. Okay. Electricity would be a fantastic draw, but we already scryed one to the bottom. Anything else? Boomerang on Boilerworks. Okay. We call that a tempo play. All right, I guess we will just kill all the creatures. All right, we're running out of resources, but I imagine my opponent's also kind of running out of resources. So, yeah, well, they had the Ninja the Deep Hours. Let's go ahead and slash it. Preordain. Bottom, top. I want to keep up Counterspell here. And play around. Days, I guess. What a grindy matchup. I found that like Pauper is way more grindy than you would initially think. With the Bone Splitter, I think I have to counter it. All right. Now we need to just find some card draw effects. I think I'd rather just have Counterspell over Peregrine Drake. Now I kind of wish I had Peregrine Drake. Actually, Peregrine Drake would be pretty bad here. Alright, well. Last threat standing wins, right? And right now, we are now behind. Wow. Yeah, we need to find, like, any number of our ways to get ahead on cards. Just can't let anything resolve right now. But yeah, just all lands. Okay. Yeah, this is kind of crazy. I mean, I guess my opponent also gushed, but and we had to 2-for-1 ourselves on the Geist, but you know, we oh my god. The trolls. Psyched me out there, you know? Alright, I'll keep this for compulsive research, but now we have more than enough lands. More than enough. Wow. This is a silly game. I mean, this is like literally anybody's game at this point, right? My opponent could have a counterspell, though, and if that's the case, then they're ahead for sure. Seagate Oracle could go all the way! Do they have like double counterspell or something? So I'm only gonna, yeah, I was only gonna attack there if this is like high risk, high reward. Well, it's not even like a great reward, but like I just lose my Seagate Oracle if my opponent has a counterspell. But like, how else am I gonna kill the Spire Golem? Yeah, my opponent. Pretty sure my opponent has a counterspell. Boomerang. Okay, that's not the worst. All right, at this point, I guess we can bounce a Life Gain land. Free Spire Golem. All right, we need to find some action. Okay, now we are very behind. It's something. It's not great, but yeah, okay. Need an answer for the Spire Golem. Yeah, the more I think about it, the more I feel like Electricery is just unnecessary, and I'd rather just have more card draw. Like, Pyroblasts, Lightning Bolts, Flame Slashes, and Firebolt is likely enough. So in like situations like this, you know, drawing Electricery is just so bad. My opponent could attack with the Geist to like upgrade it, but it doesn't seem ideal. Ninja to Depowers, yep. All right, this one is slipping away. This one is slipping away. This Bone Splitter doing a lot of work, making it so that all the creatures can trade. This is one of those games though, you know, I definitely got outplayed this game, so if I lose, you know, so be it. I mean, I guess, no, we need to find a Ghostly Flicker too, huh? We need to like somehow chain a bunch of like mole drifters or compulsive researches together. That's how we're gonna win this game, I think. Is not gonna get it done. Might as well attack. All my opponent's creatures fly. I mean, maybe compulsive research is better than Seagate Oracle. I mean, the idea behind this is that like it can block a ninja if they get a hit off of it. I don't even know what I can use to get back from that. Nope. Not good enough. 1-1 against the mono blue deck.